Friends, it is Shannon, and I am here for the June Mixed Media Frenzy YouTube Hop. And here is the layout that we are scrap lifting. And I am working on our latest Disney pictures, and this is my husband, and he is donning his favorite Stitch mask. And so for this, I did add some clear gesso, but before I did that, I wanted to put my pattern paper down because I wanted to put some gesso on top of it because I will be painting on top of it. So I'm just taking some scraps. I used all scraps on this layout. Some of them are really old. I think there was some chatterbox that I have kept probably for 2 decades. And some other older papers. And I just wanted to kind of pull that blue, different shades of blue out to go with the blues in my husband's Stitch mask. And so I'm just tearing the edges and tucking them under each other. And then I have this other piece that I'll be putting on to back my photo later. But here's where I am gonna go ahead and put the clear gesso on there. And I really like this gesso. I think it's Liquitex or something like that, but it dries really easily, and I didn't feel like it really messed up my paper too badly. So I have definitely found a favorite brand of gesso. And so while I'm waiting on that to dry, I am gonna go ahead and back my photo. I am gonna back it with some black first. Because there are going to be so many layers, I wanted to at least ground the picture with a little bit of a black background. And now I'm just going to take a bunch of papers and some other ephemera and tags and just kind of build up the layers on my photo. And so you see here I have a couple of different pattern papers, and I'm going to add those on there. And just layer those up, and then I will start layering the other side, and then I'm going to start to dig into some of my ephemera. I don't usually make quite this many layers behind my photos, but I really liked how it was on the original layout. I thought they did a really great job with adding a bunch of layers and interest, and so I really wanted to make this very fun. So hopefully I have achieved that. So now that I have my paper layers on there, I'm just looking for some of my ephemera. And I believe this is a cut apart. And I really like that yellow because there's a little bit of yellow in my husband's shirt and his hat is sort of a yellowish tan. And so I'm gonna use that and also this tag and add a little bit of colorful twine. And I have this other, I guess it would be sort of a cut apart that has some stars in it, and that's going to go in my layers as well. And so I'm just trying to figure out where I want it. With this cut apart sheet, it looked really well going horizontal. It added a little bit of the yellow on both sides, and so I really like that it did that. And I also have this little fishtailed tag that I'm going to add to the top to give it a little bit of dimension as well. And so now that my gesso is dry, I'm going to take some watercolor and just use a blue that's on this watercolor. And these watercolors aren't anything special. I just got them at an art store. I do like that they have a very vibrant color to them. And so here you'll see I'm just kind of overlapping onto some of my pattern paper where I had placed the gesso and allowing the watercolor to sort of drip. I'm not being really super particular about how I put this on there. I knew I wanted to kind of do a T shape, and I'm just gonna splatter just a few drops here and there. I did end up messing up the ones down at the bottom because I tried to absorb some of the water and it just ended up smushing it, and so I'll be covering that up later. But for now I think it looked fine, and so I'm just gonna take a minute to let that dry, and by the magic of editing it is dry and we are back, and I'm going to be layering up my photo and putting that on there so I can start embellishing. But before I do that, one of the things that I noticed that I really liked on the original layout was just some random stamping. And so I have a Disney kit and a stamp kit, and I'm not honestly sure where it came from. I believe it's LA Studios, but don't quote me. I'll have to look that up. And so I'm just adding a few stamps here or there. When I turned the camera off, I realized I wanted to add a few more stamps, and so I did do that as well. And here I have some film strip washi tape. There is a film strip on the original layout, and I really liked how that looked on there. And so I am just about done. I'm trying to figure out where I want to put the rest of my little bits and bobs, and I believe that that phrase that I just put at the bottom of the photo, I had stamped that earlier and had not used it, and so it was just sort of in my Disney ephemera that I keep. And so yeah, I'm just kind of looking to see what else I can add along that left side. And then I'll be getting out, I believe, some buttons. I have not used a lot of my blue buttons. As you can see, I keep them in a really cute little container. I think I got those containers off Amazon, and I've separated them out by color, and I really love the way it makes it so easy to be able to pick out the buttons that I want, because I do actually still use quite a few buttons on my layouts, and I love that this original layout had it. And as you can see at the bottom, where I had messed up those splatters, I ended up making a Mickey head with my buttons, which is kind of one of my favorite things to do. I love to use different things to make Mickey heads. I've done this with enamel dots, I've done them with Nuvo drops, and buttons are great too. And so now I am just going to use a combination of letter stickers and thickers, and my title is going to be Resting Stitch Face. So it was kind of a joke when we were at Disney that he said when he had it on, it gave him resting stitch face, and it kind of does. So that's going to be my title. I am going to add the word mask, I think off camera at the very end of face, but it just made me laugh when we were talking about that. And so, yeah, so it's kind of nice to be able to document some of these fun moments within the pandemic. We have been fortunate to be able to go to the theme park and really have a nice time. I think I'm going to be really spoiled because they're not very busy right now, so it's been nice to be able to go with low crowds. And even though it was record heat that day, the masks weren't too bad. So yeah, that's going to be it for me. I hope you follow along with the rest of the YouTubers. I would love it if you'd subscribe to my channel and give me a thumbs up. Take care, and I'll see you soon.